Hey there, this is Erica from Ever Educating, and this channel is all about teaching tips and resources for new college instructors, and recently a lot of edtech tutorials and tips as well for online teaching. Which free tool creates more engaging slides for your students? Mentimeter or Pear Deck? In today's video, you're going to find out because I'm comparing two of them and their features to give you a sense of what each brings on the free plan and which one I think is a better bet when you're teaching online this semester. Once you finish watching, let me know in the comments below, which one do you think is better, Mentimeter or Pear Deck?
The first feature I'm going to compare is privacy. And so the privacy settings on Mentimeter, it's very simple. You know, you sign in and create an account as a teacher, and doesn't really ask for any data because you're just creating slides on the actual app. Students sign in anonymously in the sense that they just go to a website, put in the PIN number, and then they're in. There's no way to know what student is answering for each question. So that's something to keep in mind. It has to be anonymous for students. On the other hand, with Pear Deck, you basically have to agree multiple times to share your data with Google. Because Pear Deck is an add-on to Google Slides, as you can see here. And so you do have to say, yes, Pear Deck can see all of my Google Slides data, et cetera, et cetera. So there is that element, if you're uncomfortable with, that you have to consider. Because right here, you go to add-ons, and then Pear Deck, and open it. And it opens on the right side here. So here, if you go to this icon, you can require student logins. But that means they have to sign in with a Gmail account, which again, then they have to agree to share their data. And so I keep it anonymous for that reason. I just turn that off so that students do not have to sign in. They can just go in and put in their answers, right? So obviously if you have Google Classroom or your LMS connects to Google for your students, maybe you're less concerned about that. But for me, as far as these two go, I like Mentimeter more because there's no need for students to share any data, and I'm not sharing any data with them really either because I'm just creating slides right here in the app, right? So as far as this first element go of privacy, I would give Mentimeter the point. Now, both of these apps are for creating interactive slides that can help with making your lectures more engaging or with just introducing activities for your students. Of the two, Mentimeter has a lot of different question types that you can add into the slideshow. So for example, this one is a word cloud, where as students answer, the more times a specific word is used, the bigger it is on the screen. And so you can get a discussion going based off of that information. They have multiple choice questions, open-ended, right? Where students just answer the question and they appear on the screen. You can have a Q&A where you just say, ask me anything, and then they ask you questions. Ranking. Okay, so which do you want to discuss next class period, A, B, or C, and they can rank their order. Selecting an answer, type answer, so there's a lot here. It doesn't have to be a type of question. You can just give a quote, an inspiring quote to start and end our class period. There are some tied to mathematical elements as well. Okay, so it's not just literature stuff that you can do here. So you can definitely check out here. I think there's a lot more on Mentimeter as far as slide design than with Pear Deck. When you see here, you can do these. So you can add in text where they just answer you in text, a choice one, so multiple choice. There are numbers. You can link a website to a specific slide so they can go immediately to it in case you have a question that the answer can be found on the slide or just using that slide as an example. You can add audio to slides if you want. And so there's not necessarily as many different question types as there is in Mentimeter. And so I would definitely give the point to Mentimeter as far as slide design. But for the free version of Mentimeter, you can only create two slides. You can't add any more without paying for the basic plan of $10 a month. Whereas Pear Deck, there is not that slide limitation as far as numbers go, just in how the design is. And so with Mentimeter, as you can see here, I only have two slides, and I can show you now the scales one, where you have two elements. In this case, it's low confidence and high confidence, and they put in their numbers 1 through 5. And then as you can see here, this was an example that I did where I answered this question as a student. And so you see this is showing how you see the results on your screen. And so on here, because you could only create two slides on a free account, obviously you're much more limited in slide numbers in Mentimeter than you are in Pear Deck, which would give the point to Pear Deck as far as, you know, how complex can you make your slideshow. On the other hand, one thing you can do here, as you can see, I answered this question, you could download the results and then reset them. And once it's reset, you can go ahead and ask the same questions of the next section of students for your course, and then download those results as well afterward. And then once that's done, you can have a clean slate and change these two slides into new questions to use going forward. In Pear Deck, you have as many slides as you want, but you're more limited in design. So I would give Mentimeter a point as far as design types, but I would give Pear Deck the point as far as how many slides you can create and getting a better activity going or lecture going because you have more slides to use. And as far as the data here goes, if you go to your dashboard, you can see the results as well on here. These, again, are just examples I did, and so there's not really anything that you really see here, but you can go in and you can see, you know, what were the answers that students gave. So you see that right here. So far, Mentimeter got the point for privacy. They also got the point for slide design, but Pear Deck got the point for how, you know, complexly can you make your lecture, right? Because you can use more slides with it. Now, I would say that both of them get the point as far as collecting data goes, because as I showed here, for both of them, it's very easy to download results. I would say Mentimeter is slightly faster, just because once the slideshow ends, it immediately has on the right side there, you know, download results. Whereas Pear Deck, you have to enter into your dashboard, which can take some time, and download from there. But really, it's not a big difference. So I would give both of them points for that particular element of just collecting student answers. And then moving on from there, I would also both give them the point as far as ease of access of using the slides with your students, because for both of them, all you need to do is, you know, log into a website, put in a PIN number, and then they're in the slides. And so, you know, as far as Pear Deck goes, they'll just have to click answer question on the bottom right of the screen and they can answer it. Whereas in Mentimeter, it's very similar in which they just like the answer, you know, box pops up immediately on the screen. So maybe like one less step for Mentimeter than Pear Deck. But again, they're both very easy to use from the student perspective. And I would say they're both easy to use from the teacher perspective as far as actually creating the slides. I think Mentimeter is a bit more, you know, even faster than Pear Deck, because once you have in, you choose the type, it's very easy to just add in the content. They have little bubbles for you, and then it's ready to go. Whereas in Pear Deck, you're basically curating the slides completely from scratch. So potentially Mentimeter would have a bit more of that point in as far as, you know, designing the slides goes, but it's really, again, easy for both of them. And for both of them too, you can see examples for some slide ideas, and I really like that Mentimeter has them designed by purpose, by type, by audience, whereas Pear Deck, you can go to the template library and you can see, you know, for there as well, are you looking for things for the beginning of lessons, during lessons, end? What type of learning development are you looking for? Subject areas, right? So both of them have examples to choose from. So in the end, while Mentimeter does get more points going through this list, I would say that if you're not really looking for a slide creation program that only allows you to create two slides, then Pear Deck is the way to go. Because Mentimeter might have a lot of better designs as far as their content goes, but Pear Deck allows for a much longer experience of using the slides for engagement. So that is, I'd say, a huge difference, even though it was just a 1 point difference. But if you do like the idea of having like entrance and exit cards, so one card to introduce an activity or a class period, and one card to kind of wrap up things and look ahead, then maybe Mentimeter would be for you because you can design them really, you know, in really interesting ways.
So which do you think wins this battle? Let me know in the comments. Click like and subscribe if you haven't yet. And if you have any questions, you can go ahead and let me know in the comments as well. And I have here on the screen videos that connect to other online tips that I think you'll find useful.